My name is Polawat Jalanthong Kachonchai from Material Engineering, Faculty of Engineering, Budapai University, Thailand. My topic is the effect of carbon and sulfate treatment of carbon on sulfur vulcanization reaction and properties of natural rubber composite. Before I'm going to start with my research, I would like to give you some background about the natural rubber foam process. Natural rubber foam process can produce by two main processes. First of all is the latex process that's suitable for the simple dimension of specimen. And it can produce by the Dunlop and Talley process in general. And another process is the rubber compounding process that mix the rubber with the chemical together and compress it in the mold. This is suitable for the complex shape of specimen, and it can produce by many techniques such as the Garfield bead, low boiling point of liquid, and the chemical boiling agent technique. We focus on the chemical boiling agent technique for our research. Before I'm gonna go to my research, I would like to give you some background about the mechanism of the natural rubber foam. Natural rubber foam with the chemical boiling agent technique can have to balance between the sulfur vulcanization reaction and the thermal decomposition of chemical boiling agent, because if the sulfur vulcanization rate has the faster than the thermal decomposition of chemical boiling agent, the bubble size in the rubber matrix should be smaller. In contrast, if the thermal decomposition of chemical boiling agent faster than the sulfur vulcanization reaction, some of bubble can accumulate to form a larger bubble size. The sulfur vulcanization is the sulfur that attack on the double bond of the polyisoprene to form the cross-link network. But we should not add only the sulfur vulcanization for high efficiency. So we have to add some more like an activator and accelerator to accelerate the sulfur vulcanization reaction. For the thermal decomposition, we use the azodicarbonamide, which is the one type of the chemical boiling agent. The boiling agent, when it absorbs the heat, it can produce the gas and some of byproduct. This is the mechanism of the thermal decomposition of chemical boiling agent of azodicarbonamide that can produce the hydrazodicarbonamide, uracil, ammonia, and nitrogen with carbon monoxide gas in the rubber matrix. Let's go to my research. Effect of carbon type and content on property of natural rubber foam. The type of carbon material that we try to research are the carbon black, graphite, graphene oxide, graphene multiple carbon nanotube, and carbon from agricultural waste based on the durian bark. This is the synthesized of the carbon from the durian bark. You can see the shape. It has a graphite shape and the average size around 32.45 micron. And after that, we mix it with the natural rubber at 0 to 5 PHR to observe the property of natural rubber foam composites. This is the cure rate of the natural rubber foam composite when measured by the moving diariometer. And you can see that when we increase the carbon content, the cure rate should increase due to the high thermal conductivity of the carbon. From the results of the cure rate, the sulfur vulcanization rate increased with the amount of carbon. So the bubble size and the bulk density should be reduced too. After that, we try to test the mechanical property. For the mechanical property of the chain size and modulus, you can see that when we increase the carbon content, the tensile stress and Young modulus should increase. But for the tensile stress at 3 PHR, it after 3 PHR, it doesn't change after that. And for the elongation effect, it can conclude that the elongation effect should not change. After that, we set at 3 PHR of the carbon content and various the type of carbon, such as the carbon black, graphene, graphite, graphene oxide, multiple carbon nanotube, and carbon from durian bark. And you can see the cure rate of the graphene show the highest cure rate And for the morphology, the in figure F and figure G, the multiple carbon nanotube and graphene show the smaller size of bubble inside the rubber matrix. This should be because the two reasons. First is the high viscous force, high viscous of the carbon material and natural rubber foam due to the high surface area and low bulk density. And another thing is the it can increase the sulfur vulcanization reaction rate. After that, we test the mechanical property and we found that natural rubber foam with the multiple carbon nanotube show the highest mechanical property. Generally, when we add the carbon into the rubber, it shows some accumulation between particles, resulting in poor mechanical property. So we try to treat surface of carbon for increase the dispersibility. And we present the two methods of the functionalized graphene oxide. First, we try to increase the dispersibility by graph the graphene oxide with epoxidized natural rubber via aminosilane linkage. First of all, we add the aminosilane into the graphene oxide to form the graphene oxide grafted with aminosilane. And we graft the ENI onto the amide group of the graphene oxide grafted with aminosilane to form some of the ENR molecule cover on the graphene oxide surface. We confirm this mechanism by using the FTAR. For the left-hand side of this graph, it shows the synthesized ENR from our synthesis. And this piece shows the character of the ENR after we synthesize from the natural rubber sheet. And the right-hand side shows the FTAR of the graphene oxide particle. For the graphene oxide, it shows the hydroxyl group, carboxylic group, carbonyl group, and epoxide group on surface of graphene. After we graph with the aminosilane, it shows CH2-CH2 stretching, which is the structure of the aminosilane. And when we graph it with the ENR, it shows the peak that identify the ENR character on the graphene oxide surface. After that, we observe the graphene oxide without treatment and graphene oxide grafted with ENR by using a transmission electron microscope. You can see that when we graft it with ENR, it shows some of molecule of ENR on graphene oxide surface. And we also improve the dispersibility by mix the graphene oxide and graphene oxide grafted with ENR with natural rubber at 10% by weight. And you can see the better dispersibility of graphene oxide grafted with ENR. Next, we're gonna present our other technique to graft graphene. We use the cycloacylamine and diazonium reaction to graft the cycloacylamine on graphene oxide surface. This is the possible mechanism of the graphene oxide grafted with cycloacylamine. First, it formed the free radical of the cycloacylamine, and the free radical of cycloacylamine can attack directly to the graphene oxide surface without other cross-link with the chemical function. We also use the FTAR to confirm our functionalization. For the treated graphene, it shows CH2-CH2 stretching from the cycloacylamine in our research. And we also observe the dispersibility of the treated graphene and untreated graphene in natural rubber matrix. And you can see that the treated graphene show the better dispersion. After that, we test the Keel behavior of treated and untreated graphene at 3 PSR to compare what happened of the sulfur vulcanization rate when we functionalize the graphene. And you can see that natural rubber form with chemical functionalized or treated graphene show the slower cure rate than the untreated at 3 pHr. This can support by Wu and co-worker. Wu and co-worker found that the oxygen functional group on surface of graphene can react with the sulfur to form thiol and thioester, and thiol and thioester can accelerate the sulfonamide type of sulfur vulcanization reaction to form the cross-link reaction. So for our research, we use the cycloxylamine that some of amine, which is the base, can react with the carboxylic or hydroxyl group on the surface of graphene oxide. So it should be retard the sulfur vulcanization reaction rate. We also observe the morphology of the functionalized graphene, and you can see in figure D and E, which is the untreated, which are the untreated and treated graphene at 3 pHr. You can see different morphology. For the treated graphene, it shows uniform and smaller size of the bubble inside the rubber matrix, and you can see the thicker cell wall. We also confirm about the thicker cell wall by calculate the cell density, which means the amount of bubble inside the rubber matrix. And you can see when we functionalize graphene oxide, it shows the lowest cell density in the rubber matrix. From the lowest density, and the thicker cell wall, it show the highest mechanical property because the tensile strength, some elongation at rate, and compression set depend on the cell wall of the natural rubber foam. To conclusion, high amount of carbon can increase the sulfur vulcanization reaction due to it. High thermal conductivity resulting in the small bubble size in rubber matrix. And it also increase the tensile stress and modulus, but it doesn't change the elongation at rate. For the different type of carbon, it show the different sulfur vulcanization rate due to the character of the carbon material that we use. And we found that natural rubber foam with multi-wall carbon nanotube show the high mechanical property with the small bubble size. For the surface treatment with the graphene and aminosyl linkage and the diazonium reaction, it can increase the dispersibility of the graphene in the rubber matrix. And the bubble size with mechanical property depend on the functional life of the chemical treatment on graphene oxide surface. This is my reference and this is my personal contact. If you have any question, I'm welcome to answer you. Thank you.